Hey guys, welcome back to Cooking with RadEconomist. Do not do that shit with me today. God damn it. Welcome back to Cooking with RadEconomist. Washiri RadEconomist. Today I am going to show you my egusi recipe. You've all been asking for this egusi recipe, so I've decided to give it to you before you people come and kill me. There are two ways in which I make this. There's a stewed way, and then there's just the normal frying in palm oil way.
I hope you're paying attention.
There are various ways to make egusi. A lot of people make it in a lot of different ways. But I showed you my quick way on Instagram when I was at my sister's place when she was pregnant. But now I'll actually show you my in-depth recipe.
If you like, don't pay attention.
It's not that hard, nothing fancy. The only ingredient there that you typically might have to search for is the ogiri. But aside that, basic stuff. Let's do this. Okay guys, here are my ingredients. I've got my egusi, I've got my assorted meat, I've got my fish, hake and mackerel already seasoned. I will list the seasonings I used for this. I've got my palm oil, I've got my bell peppers and my chili peppers to substitute for the fact that I don't have an onion pepper. I'm using onions for the meat. I've got my stockfish, crayfish. I've got my Knorr cubes, ginger, thyme and curry to season up my meat. I've got my ogiri to add flavor to my egusi as well. And I've got my spinach to finish it all off. That is it, let's get started. Instead of bell peppers, and it looks like this, but unfortunately I don't have any anaheim pepper, so I will be using bell pepper and I will be mixing it with chili pepper to kind of, you know, create hot pepper kind of feeling, if you dig what I'm saying. This love, baby, this love. This love, baby, some crazy love.